Hi guys, welcome back. This is part 7 of the Pocket Mouse. Now, the next couple of videos are going to cover how to do the eyes. And I broke up the videos because each video is going to do an option for the eyes. So part 7, we are going to be sewing in some beads. And they're tiny beads with a hole in them. And I'm still able to get a sewing needle through that hole. And I'm also using embroidery thread or regular sewing thread will work as well. And you can look in the description box below and see the other videos that are available. So if you don't want to do beads, you don't need to watch this video. You can look in that description box and see what the other options are. For this one, grab a couple of beads, a sewing needle, and some thread, and let's get started. Alright, so what I do first on these little guys is I get a couple of pins. And I'm going to use these as markers. Because it depends on where you want to put the eyes. You want to play around with the placement, then you can do that with these pins. Just be careful when you push them through that you don't stab yourself. I've done that before, and it does not feel very good. All right, you can see it comes right through the back side. So you can play around with it. I think this is in between the fourth and fifth row. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, yeah. On these little ones, it's really hard to determine exactly row count and stuff, because we're all going to be a little bit different the way we stuff and shape. Putting the eyes on the same row count on yours might not look good. So pins are a good idea to play around with. Okay, I got my two beads ready there, and I got my needle, a regular sewing needle, and some thread. This is actually embroidery thread. It's punch embroidery thread, but regular sewing thread will work just fine. And you can see it's way too long for what I need it for, but much easier to work with something too long than something that's too short. And this thread is going to do both eyes. So when we go in, we're going to go through the back, go through a stitch hole. You're going to use the same stitch hole for both eyes. So every time you go in and come out through the same stitch hole. And that's very important because this little guy here, his eyes were sewn in and you cannot see where that thread is. And I'm going to show you how to make that thread disappear once we get the eyes in place. It's going through a stitch hole and then coming up right where that pin head is. You can take the pin out now and put your bead right over the needle and then pull your thread through. And I'm going to pull it almost all the way through. I'm going to leave a little bit here that I'm going to work with after because I need to knot off the thread tails too. So just make sure you have a little bit hanging out there that you can work with. And when you go back down into the head, you have to go over a little bit and make sure you're piercing the yarn so that the bead doesn't get pulled through when you pull the yarn tails through. And out through the same stitch hole. And then pull it through. Okay, before pulling it all the way through, I like to do an extra step. Don't look at the brand of this one. I wouldn't use this one again. I would use fabric glue or regular white tacky glue works wonders. It dries clear and it really grabs those beads. When you pull this down, guide it in so that there's no hole of that bead sticking upward. You don't want the hole sticking out. You just want to see the bead. And then you can pull pretty tight. It sucks that eye in a little bit. Looks a little bit more natural. Okay, now I'm going to knot these two off. Okay, I'm going to go through the same stitch hole and then come up where the other pin head is. And pull that thread through. Going back in with my needle and out through the same stitch hole. And remember before pulling it all the way through, if you want to, you can skip this step. The thread will hold it just fine. But I'm just going to go do the extra step and put a little bit of glue in there. And again, fabric glue or white tacky glue would work great. Okay, now you can just knot these two off. And now you can take the needle and go through there one more time. And we're going to carry that knot inside the head. So just take your needle and pull it out anywhere away from that area. And you're just going to pull that knot into the head. Okay, so I'm going to pull on this slightly, pull on it, and then snip. Okay, get a bigger needle here and push that back in the, yeah, there we go. Okay, now this one is just the tail, so I'm going to cut that one free. And then I can reach in here with my yarn needle. And pull that thread away from there. And there we go. Alright guys, that's the end of this video. You can watch the next video where I'm going to show you how to sew in some eyes just using some regular embroidery thread, or you can split some yarn. So I'll see you in the next video.